I'm David Whiting with the Orange County Register. Welcome to another edition of How Tough Are You? Today we are on safari in Africa and we'll be there for the next few days.
Now we're crossing parts of the Serengeti. It is one rocking ride.
Off to a great start with buffalo. Buffalo are one of the big five that hunters used to look for, and photographers now do. Why the big five? Because these are the animals that will try to kill you if you get between them and their babies, or if you just wound them. So photography's best. The buffalo, leopards, lions, rhinos, and elephants. Unfortunately, rhinos are nearly extinct because of poaching. The wildebeest that you see running across the screen and the zebras are all part of the great migration in Africa. Every year, 300,000 zebra and 1.5 million wildebeest travel in a vast circle following the rains and the grasses. Of course, all of these animals, it also means to the predators, there's a lot of food. If you've seen The Lion King, you know the name of this animal in Swahili. That's right, Simba. There are actually three male lions right next to me as I take these pictures. Two are here and one is just behind, but they're on the prowl and they're not going to stick around for very long.
Here comes the buck. Notice the M's on their backs. McDonald's for lions.
Lots and lots and lots of hippos.
Until I visited this particular hippo pool, I thought I'd like to be reincarnated as one. It seemed like a great life just hanging out in the water, but boy oh boy, this water, I'll tell you, it smells about as good as it looks. These bad boys can go all the way up to about 3 tons, and they are considered the third largest land animal in the world, right behind white rhinos and elephants. That was the call of an African elephant in the wild, in this case, a baby. This herd is one of many in the Serengeti, and you also see them in Lake Manyara as well as the Ngorongoro Crater. Elephants, the good news is they've really made a comeback in Africa. These are the largest land mammals, and African elephants are bigger than Asian elephants. The African elephant, of course, uses those big ears to cool off. There's thousands of tiny capillaries in the backs of the ears, and that's why they flap them to stay cool.
It's dawn in the Ngorongoro Crater, and a cheetah is stalking its prey. It's just behind it. A hyena follows in the distance.
You've heard that cheetahs are fast. Well, this one's taking it pretty easy right now. But yes, they are fast. They can go up to 75 miles an hour in short bursts. Yes, there are ostriches in Africa as well as in Australia. The females have gray plumage, and look at the feathers on this beautiful creature. It's really a difference between the zoos and in the wild. The males, of course, have slightly darker plumage and also are larger.
Hyena moving across the grass. Mama hyena and her suckling baby. It's Pumbaa from The Lion King. Dig it up. On his knees, getting his breakfast. Okay, we've got another one of the big boys. Four lions at the watering hole. I think I'm gonna stay inside this Land Rover here.
Again, another Simba. This lion, or really lioness, is on the prowl. You can see that the wildebeest in the background have a rule. They don't go closer than 50 yards to any lion or lioness for that matter. She's not only on the prowl for prey, but she's also looking for her mates. I wanted to wrap up this little video with what I think is Africa's most graceful creature, and that is, of course, the giraffe. These magnificent beasts can weigh up to 2,600 pounds. They are 20 feet tall, and the adults are pretty much invulnerable to any kind of prey. They can kick a lion, for example, with just a leg. The calves, however, that's a different story. They're pretty vulnerable. And for you moms wondering, how does a giraffe ever have a calf? It's not an easy thing, and gestation takes as long as 450 days. I'm David Whiting with the Orange County Register. Thanks for joining me.